Hi, my name's Gina. Welcome to Patrick Cat's Place. I'm going to do a review of the two magazines I got in the mail recently. But before I start those, I'll just let you know what I'm playing on the record player. Elvis's Greatest Hits Volume 1, which is an Australian pressing. I bought it at picked it up at a record shop the other day. Very happy with it. The Wonder of You, which is live. Big Hunk of Love, an unreleased live version. There Goes My Everything. Suspicious Minds and What Did I Say, an unreleased live version. So when that's finished, I'll be going on to side two, so I'll be hopping up from the magazines. Hopefully I'll be finished the magazines before that happens. Okay, so the first one is Elvis Presley Memorial Edition. This was published in 1977, England, English magazine. The pages are starting to yellow, but it's that's all right. It's still in pretty good condition for its age. We came to tell him we love him. This is the people that turned up at Elvis's funeral. Burt Reynolds, Sammy Davis, was Anne Margaret and Roger Smith, Carolyn Kennedy. There's some really good text in this magazine. We have just witnessed what the world will always remember as one of the saddest moments in its history. And yet, in some ways, it was also one of the proudest moments as well. The world came out to honour a man whose humble beginnings hardly gave any hint of the greatness that would lie ahead. The world came out to honour a man who rose to staggering heights of fame and who blazed his name into immortality. The world, both great and small among us, poured out its love for Elvis Presley, both during his life and certainly after his death. Yeah, that's really nice. I like that. Where it all began. Again, photos we've all seen before, but it doesn't matter. Well, there's a few photos in between them. In between the common ones that pop up that we haven't seen before. Oh, hello. The cat started meowing. Next thing that'll happen is a bloody phone will ring. Well, I shouldn't. 10:15 at night. Nice shot, very nice shot. If I wasn't so much against wrecking my magazines, I'd pull that out and put it up somewhere. Shot too. cousin, Billy Smith. This was in 1958, I guess. Yeah, 1958. Didn't say how old he was, but he obviously only a kid. Nice shot. Elvis with his fans. Various girlfriends, co-stars. That's about her, the better. Glue those pages together, I think. Not Lisa. Photoshop, I think I've seen that before. Yeah, so nice magazine. Next one, series number one, Rock Legends, Elvis. Another English one. This is interesting. It's an A to Z of the King of Rock and Roll, but it's not an A to Z of the usual way of the various books that have been put out. It's been 5 years since the King of Rock and Roll died. In this publication, we've attempted to provide some information about the people involved in the story of Elvis Presley, the places which are notable for their Elvis connections, and the public and private Elvis. So, it goes on. Yep, that's good. This is a bit, what's 5 years? After the other one was published, so it's in better condition. It's glossy photos, glossy paper, it's printed on, I mean. And some nice photos, love that one. And the text on each person or segment is quite good and interesting, different perspective from most of the other magazines that are put out. His films might have been very good in the 60s, but God, he was handsome. That's another nice shot. Wow. Yeah, so they're the magazines. Now, the book that I also got the other day in a op shop. Before Elvis, there was nothing. Now, I think I did a review of this once before, but this video's only been going for 9 minutes, so I think I can run it through again in case anybody missed it the first time. Before Elvis, there was nothing. Patrick Higgins, published in 1994. Quite a good write-up on this guy's impressions of when he first got to know who Elvis was and about him. And And the text is just different things that people have said about, well, in this case, what Elvis said about himself. The image is one thing, human beings another. Very hard to live up to the image. Be big. He used to come around and be around us a lot. There was a place we used to go and hang out at on Beale Street. We used to hang out and play. That was the first place I met him. That's a well-known photo. Pages are thick. Half the time you don't know if you've missed one. I have missed one. Here we are. I love these shots with the back of Elvis looking out and his fans all going nuts. One big hunk of forbidden fruit, a young female fan. What did I say? The unreleased live version. I've actually got two copies of this book now, so I'll be sending one over to one of my YouTube friends that's sending some stuff to me in the mail. It's great being able to swap stuff. Sadness never really goes away, does it? When you think about Elvis dying. Yeah, so, good book. I also bought the other day at the record shop, the second-hand record shop, had this jigsaw puzzle, which one of my girlfriends who's helping me do the gold suit jigsaw. I told her I had this. She said, I better hurry up and finish the other one for you, hadn't I? I said, well, no. I like help. I don't want you to finish it for me. I just want help doing it. But yeah, I think this will probably be the next one rather than the other six I've got. There's only 500 pieces in this, so let's hope they're all there. And finally, I'll do a separate video for this one. It's arrived today. Elvis the Complete Movie Masters, put out by Memphis Recording Service, not FTD. Let's see if I can do this. It sort of looks, well, it looks small. It's a bunch of, well, it's a bunch, set of CDs. With the Complete Movie Masters 1960-62. And there's four CDs in there with the original movie tracks, and then the other CDs are the outtakes. Anyway, sorry, I'll go right through it in a separate video. Back shortly. Bye.